Hello friends, welcome back to sakalvidya.com. In today's session, we are going to have a discussion on level 5 concepts and solve numerical examples. So level 5 concepts and numerical examples. So concept number 1, the amount of work done in expansion of a gas at constant pressure is given by work done is equal to P into det V, where P is nothing but constant pressure and delta V is nothing but change in volume. Change in volume. For example, if V1 is our, for example, V1 is our initial volume, Vf be our final volume. So what is our change in volume? That is det V is equal to final volume minus initial volume. So what is the formula to calculate work done? Work done is equal to pressure into change in volume, where P is our constant pressure and dV is nothing but change in volume. Change in volume. So we can also get a graph which is plotted between, which is also plotted between pressure and volume. Same like your force and displacement curve, same like your force and displacement curve. So the graph between force and displacement curve, the area is going to give your work done. In similar fashion, when a graph is plotted between pressure and volume, the area is going to give your work done also. So for example, this is our curve. So area of this curve is going to give our work done, similar to our force versus displacement curve. So now pressure versus volume curve. So the area of pressure and volume curve is also going to give our work done. Remember this concept. So let us solve one question on this. So a gas expands from 2 liters to 5 liters at a constant pressure of 2 into 10 power 5. So what is the work done? So here, before solving this, guys, remember 1 liter is approximately equal to 1 by 1000 cubic meter, which is approximately equal to 0.001 cubic meter. So 1 liter of volume is approximately equal to 0.001 cubic meters. So this conversion is very, very important in solving this question, because initially our gas units are in liters, so we have to convert into cubic meters. So 1 liter is equal to 0.01 cubic meters. So what is given in the question? So given data, initial volume is given, that is of 2 liters. So we have to convert into cubic meters, then it becomes 0.002 cubic meters. Next, final volume, Vf is equal to 5 liters. You have to convert into cubic meters, then it becomes 0.005 cubic meters. Next, constant pressure, that is 2 into 10 power 5 2 into 10 power 5 newton per meter square. So we have to find work done. So what is the formula for work done? Work done, when a constant pressure is given, P into delta V, where P is our constant pressure. So constant pressure, according to our question, it is 2 into 10 power 5 into velocity final minus velocity initial. So change in volume, sorry, it's not velocity, it is volume. So final volume minus initial volume. So 2 into 10 power 5 into 0.005 minus 0.002. So 2 into 10 power 5 into 0.003. So our work done will be 600 joules. So what is the work done? 600 joules. So what is the formula for this? P into delta V, where P is constant pressure and det V is nothing but change in volume. Okay. So the graph between pressure and volume, or pressure versus volume, is also going to give our work done. So you may also get questions based upon graphs also. Okay, now let us go for concept number 2. The amount of work done in pulling the bob of a simple pendulum of length L such that it makes an angle theta with the vertical support is given by work done is equal to mgl times of 1 minus cos theta. So in your intermediate first year, I have seen the time period derivation for a simple pendulum. So a simple pendulum which is connected to a fixed support which is hanging vertically, so when you're going to apply a force, it is going to make some oscillations in to and fro motions. So we have found the time period, that is nothing but t is equal to something, you're going to get approximately the time period for simple pendulum, t is equal to 2 pi times of L by G, where is L is the length of the pendulum, G is the acceleration due to gravity. So this is the time period, and I have seen seconds pendulum. So for this derivation, go and refer our playlist. We did some videos on this time period for simple pendulum and seconds pendulum. But in this case, we are going to find work done. This work done by the gravitational force is also called as Wg. So work done by the gravitational force is nothing, is equal to mgl times of 1 minus cos theta. So let us derive it. Initially, so a pendulum or for a vertical string, a bob of mass m is connected, where the length of the pendulum is L meters. So when you are going to apply a force, what happens to the pendulum? It starts oscillating in to and fro motion. It is going to make some to and fro motion, isn't it? So when you are going to apply a force, it is going to move in to and fro motion. So at this point, let us zoom it. So at this point B, when you zoom it, you're going to get like this. So this is our string. So in string, one force is going to act, that is T, which is nothing but tension in string. T is nothing but tension in string. So which is balanced by, which is equally balanced by mg cos theta. So our gravitational force of bob is going to act like this, that is mg. So for this perpendicularly, one more force is going to act, that is called as a restoring force, which is exactly perpendicular to our mg cos theta. So that is our mg sin theta. So mg sin theta is called as restoring force. Restoring force. So what is the meaning of restoring force? This mg sin theta plays an important role in bringing back from position B to mean position A. For example, if this is our mean position A, again it is going to reach C. Again, this mg sin theta is going to pull our bob to our mean position. So whenever it is going to, our bob is going to reach at B position, which force is going to bring back its bob to its mean position? Mg sin theta. That is nothing but a restoring force. That is called as restoring force. So where T is the tension in string, this tension in string is balanced by mg cos theta. So T is our tension in string, which is balanced by mg cos theta. The acceleration due to gravity, the restoring force, which is an important force which get backs or bring backs our bob to its mean position, that is nothing but mg cos theta. But now in this case we need to find work done by gravitational force. Work done by gravitational force, that is Wg, is how much? So again let us consider a support from which a string is connected. So for this, a bob of mass is placed whose mean position is A. So when you're going to apply a force, what happens? It is going to oscillate in to and fro motion, and it's going to reach position A, sorry B. Again, it is going to come back to position A. Again, it is going to reach C. So if you're going to join this, the length of this string is L. If the length of the string is L, the length of the string is L, so let it assume as fixed support as O. So OA is equal to L. In similar fashion, OB is also L, OC is also L, OC is also L, OB is also L. So let us assume our datum line or reference line is going to pass exactly from the center of mass of our bob. So as our bob is going to reach from A to O, it is going to make small displacement of h units. In similar fashion, from A to C is going to make a small displacement of h units. So now let us join these points. So we are going to get a rectangle where this is D and this is E. So we are going to get a rectangle which is in the form of somewhere here we are going to have our bob, where this is our initial position A and this is our bob at B. So we have named it as D, we have named it as E. So what is the displacement made by the bob? That is BE is nothing but how much? H. From the symmetry of rectangle, if BE is equal to DA, which is nothing but H, So but initially, the initial length of our pendulum is L units. So what is the total length? The total length from here to here is how much? L units. So okay, I will draw it again, don't worry. So this is our rigid support. This is our bob of mass M. This is our initial mean position A. So our bob is going to make some distance of in this fashion, and finally it is going to reach a position of B. So this distance we are going to name it as E and this as D. So this distance is how much? H units. From the symmetry of a rectangle, AD is also H units. But what is the total length? What is the total length of the pendulum? That is nothing but L. So remember, AD is equal to AD AD is equal to BE is equal to H. But AO is our total length of our simple pendulum. But we need to find the distance of AD. So AD is equal to the total distance of our pendulum. So one second, this is not working properly, let me get it. So AD is equal to AO minus AO minus OD. So what is AO? What is the total length of AO? Is nothing but L. L minus OD. But we don't know this length OD. Okay, now let us join this line. Then it becomes a right angle triangle in the form of ODB. It becomes a triangle, right angle triangle. O D B, where this is our theta. So according to this diagram, what is the total length of OB? Is nothing but L. So OB is nothing but L. So cos theta is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. So cos theta is equal to OD. What is the length of OD? It is not given. OD divided by L. So according to this geometry, our OD is how much? So OD is equal to L cos theta. So let us substitute this OD is equal to L cos theta in our previous equation. Then our value of AD becomes L minus L cos theta. So this AD becomes L minus L cos theta. But our AD is how much? H. H is equal to how much? L minus L cos theta. So what is the displacement made by our simple pendulum? H is equal to, if L is common, L minus 1 cos theta. So what is the basic formula for work done? F dot S, which means M into G into S. So in the place of S, we are going to substitute this displacement. Then it becomes work done is equal to M into G into L divided by 1 minus cos theta. So this is our formula for work done. But according to our trigonometric identities, 1 minus cos theta is also equal to 2 sin square theta. If you are going to substitute this, our formula again becomes work done is equal to mgl times of 2 sin square theta. So then it becomes 2 mgl sin square theta. So work done for a simple pendulum by the gravity is 2 mgl sin square theta, or work done is equal to mgl times of 1 minus cos theta. We can use any of these formulas for work done by the gravity. Now let us solve one question on this. A simple pendulum is of 1.6 meters and mass of 0.9 kgs. So length 1.6 meters and mass of 0.9 kgs, and makes an angle of 60 degrees, and acceleration due to gravity is 10 meter per second square. So what do you have to find? Work done. So a simple pendulum which is connected to a fixed support whose mass is of 0.9 kgs. The length of the pendulum is how much? 1.6 meters. When a force is applied, it makes it to and fro oscillations. So what do you have to find here? Work done. For a simple pendulum, work done for the gravity is given as work done is equal to mgl times of 1 minus cos theta. So what is the mass? It is 0.9 kgs. Acceleration due to gravity in this question is given as 10 meter per second. Length of our pendulum is 1.6 meters into 1.6. So what is the angle made by the pendulum? So angle made by the pendulum theta is equal to how much? 60 degrees. So 1 minus cos 60 degrees. So if we are going to solve this, the work done by the gravitational force, we are going to get approximately something 7.2 joules. So concept 3, the work done in displacing a pendulum from angle theta 1 to theta 2. Everything is similar, but your angle changes. So the formula for work done is equal to mgl times of cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. Now let us solve one question on this. A bob of mass m is nothing but 0.5 kgs and length of 2 meters. When it is pulled aside, initially it makes an angle theta 1 is equal to 90 degrees and theta 2 is equal to 45 degrees with a vertical support. Find the work done. Find the work done. So what is the formula for work done? So work done is equal to mgl times of cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. So cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. So m, so mass of the bob is how much? 0.5. acceleration due to gravity is 10. I think it is given in the question. Length of the pendulum is how much? 2 meters. 2. So cos 90 degrees minus cos 45 degrees. We are going to solve this. The work done by the pendulum, we are going to get approximately 7.07 joules. So minus, we are going to get answer in minus 7.07 joules. Okay. Concept number 4. The amount of work done in pulling a metal rod of length L such that it makes an angle of theta with a vertical is given by mgl by 2 times of 1 minus cos theta by 2. So remember students, everything is similar to our simple pendulum, but displacement here will be L by 2. Everything is similar to our simple pendulum case, but displacement there in that case is L, but here it is L by 2. Let us see why. So this is our rod whose mass is of M. So when it is pulled aside, it is going to make an angle of theta with a fixed support. Whose length of this metal rod is L meters, which is fixed from a rigid support. So somewhere here exactly our center of mass is going to act. The center of mass is going to act at a distance of L by 2, exactly at the center, symmetry of the section, L by 2. So, remember, center of mass is going to act at a distance of L by 2. The whole weight of this, whole mass of this metal rod is going to concentrate here. So, the displacement made by the object is H. So, H is equal to, S is equal to L by 2. As the center of mass is going to concentrate here, so S is equal to L by 2. So, the work done by simple pendulum is how much? Mgs times of 1 minus cos theta. But in this case, S is nothing but displacement made by our metal rod. So, as displacement made by our metal rod is how much? L by 2. So, our work done will be MgL by 2 times of 1 minus cos theta. As our CM is going to act exactly at L by 2 distance, symmetry of the section. Now, let us solve one question on this. So, find the amount of work done in pulling a metal rod of length 5 meters such that it makes an angle of 30 degrees with the vertical whose mass is of 0.3 kgs. Length 5 meters, it makes an angle of 30 degrees. Next, mass is of 0.3 kgs and acceleration due to gravity is given as g as 10 meter per second square. So, what you have to find here? Work done. So, what is the formula for work done for a metal rod? When it is pulled aside, work done will be mgL by 2 times of 1 minus cos theta. So, what is the mass? It is of 0.3 kgs. Acceleration due to gravity is 10. Length of this rod is 5 meters. 5 divided by 2 into 1 minus cos. What is the angle made by this? That is 30 degrees. Cos 30 degrees. So, if you are going to solve this, work done will be approximately, you are going to get the answer as 1.004 joules. So, my dear students, remember, for a simple pendulum, work done by the gravitational force will be mgL 1 minus cos theta. Whereas, when a metal rod is fixed, when it makes an angle, when you are going to apply force, so work done will be mgL by 2 1 minus cos theta. Why L by 2? That is, the center of mass is going to act the displacement exactly at the L by 2, the distance of L by 2. So, remember these two important formulas. One is simple pendulum, next a metal rod. So, concept number 5, a ladder of mass m and length L is resting on a level of a floor, is lifted and held against the wall of an angle whose theta with the floor. So, work done will be mgL by 2 sin theta. So, initially, a ladder which is placed on the horizontal surface. For example, one person want to paint a wall. So, he is going to lift this. He is going to lift this ladder against the wall, which makes an angle of theta with the horizontal ground. So, what is the work done in raising this ladder and placed against the wall? Now, let us see. So, this is our ladder, whose length is of L meters. So, this is our wall whose height is capital H, which makes an angle theta with the ground surface. So, let L be the length of ladder, H is, capital H will be the our height of building, So, theta is angle between ladder and ground surface. So, when it is placed against the wall, So, remember students, let us name them. This is A, this is B, this is C. Okay. So, our center of gravity is going to act exactly at a distance of L by 2. So remaining distance will be L by 2. Our remaining distance will be L by 2. Okay. So the center of gravity which is going to act will let us assume as it is at the height of h from the ground surface. This is E, this is D. Now let us, in order to solve this, let us assume this triangle ADE. Let us take this triangle ADE. So this is A, this is B, this is C. So a ladder is placed against the wall, but our center of gravity is going to act here at a distance of L by 2. So from the ground level, this distance will be H. The total distance of wall will be H, capital H. So this is D, this is E. So now let us assume this what we call this triangle in order to find work done. Small triangle, that is how much? This is A, this is E, D. So this is our small h. Let small h be the displacement made by the ladder. Displacement of ladder. And this distance is L by 2, this theta. So what is AD? L by 2. So what is ED? H, displacement made by the ladder. So ADE, if this is H, this is L by 2, if this is theta, sin theta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. So what is our opposite side? DE divided by hypotenuse, that is AD. So sin theta is equal to, so what is the length of DEH divided by L by 2. So what is the length of AD hypotenuse? L by 2. So H is equal to L by 2 sin theta. H is equal to L by 2 sin theta. So from this, if we are going to solve this, we are going to get H is equal to L by 2 sin theta, which is nothing but our displacement. So what is our basic formula for work done? Work done is equal to M into G into S. So in the place of S, we are going to substitute L by 2 sin theta. So we are going to get M into G into L by 2 sin theta. So what is the formula when a ladder is placed against the wall, raised against the wall? So what is the work done formula for that? So work done will be MG L by 2 sin theta. Now let us calculate some solved example on this. A person is painting a house as he stands on a ladder whose mass is 6 kgs and height of the building is 2 meters, where the length of the ladder is 5 meters and makes an angle of 30 degrees with the ground level. Find the work done. So the mass of the person is 6 kgs, height capital H is nothing but 2 meters, length of the ladder is how much? 5 meters, which makes an angle theta is equal to 30 degrees. So acceleration due to gravity is 10 meter per second square. Or anything, you can take 9. Okay, for example, let us take 9.81 meter per second square. 9.81 meter per second square. So what you have to find work done is how much? So this is our ground surface. So this is our building on which a ladder is placed. So what is the height of the building? H is equal to 2 meters. So what is the length of the ladder? 5 meters. Here a person is standing and he wants to paint this wall. So what is the angle made by the ladder and the horizontal ground surface? That is 30 degrees. Theta is equal to 30 degrees. So what is the formula for work done? Work done is equal to M into G into L by 2 into sin theta. So mass of the person is 6 kgs. So 6 into 9.81 into length of the ladder is 5. 5 divided by 2 into sine 30 degrees. If you're going to solve this, you're going to get the answer as approximately 73.57 joules. 575 joules. So the work done for constant pressure and changing volume, the work done formula will be P into det V. The work done for a simple pendulum, when it is going to oscillate in to and fro motion, the formula will be work done is equal to MGL times of 1 minus cos theta. If there is change in displacement, change in angles, then MGL times of cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. So what is the work done when a metal rod is placed horizontally, sorry, vertically? So it becomes MGL by 2 1 minus cos theta. So what is the work done in placing a ladder against the wall? So work done will be MGL by 2 sin theta. So MGL by 2 sin theta. So when you're going to plot a graph between, so when you're going to plot a graph between pressure and volume, the area of that is going to give our work done. So area of the curve between pressure and volume is going to give our work done, similar to our force versus displacement curve, same as our force versus displacement curve. So pressure versus volume curve is going to give work done. So remember this concept. So let us, in our next class, let us have some discussion on power and some level 1 problems on that. Thank you.